Father, we thank you today for the victory. For this is the victory that overcomes. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Lord, we thank you that your word is in my heart, is in my life. My mouth, glory, the word of faith. Oh God, we thank you. We give you praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Everybody just say in Jesus' name. All right. Almost had a prayer meeting. What you need, man? All right. We just thank God for the you that's here today, and we just want to. Hallelujah, my son. Oh, my God. Why don't you just call everybody down to the altar? Hello. So go ahead. All right. I just want to admonish you this morning in the word in the area of understanding our rights and privileges in Christ. Just want to, whatever. However it comes out, it's going to be it, but I've been just so impacted with the teachings that revolve around the benefits and the blessings that our redemption gives us. I've just been really caught up in that. I guess a fresh revelation of how our redemption has been perfectly perfected, and how Jesus has done all that he needs to do and all that he's going to do. But I appreciate the redemptive work of Christ that took place over 2,000 years ago. Amen. And the present day ministry, everybody understand that Jesus wasn't completed with his work after he ascended to his Father and began to act as our high priest, our mediator, and our Savior and our Lord. Jesus is at the right hand of God. The Bible says he's able to save them to the uttermost, those that come to God through him. Amen. Ever living to make intercession. Christ is at the right hand of God. He's making intercession for me. Intercession for you. Amen. It's because of this intercessory ministry, this mediatorial ministry, is the reason why we enjoy all of the blessings and privileges that we have today. Amen. If Jesus had died and became sin for us and was and suffered and went through all of the things that he experienced, and even defeated Satan and ascended to the Father to offer up his blood. Amen. If he had stopped at that and not got involved in the ministry that he's involved with today, we still wouldn't have salvation. Amen. The provisions would have been made, but you still need a mediator. How many can say amen? There's only one mediator between God and man, the man who is Jesus Christ. Okay, I want to read the scripture, 1 Corinthians 1:30. I'm going to talk about maybe a few things in regard of how you can enjoy your share of all of the provisions and blessings that Christ has atoned for. Amen. In his redemptive work. 1 Corinthians 1:30, he lays out the main components that Christ has done for us. 1:30. 1 Corinthians 1:30. It says, but of him are ye in Christ Jesus. And I think that's very significant, in Christ Jesus. That word occurs about 130 times in the New Testament. We're in Christ, in Christ, in Christ, in Christ, in Christ. We no longer belong to the kingdom of darkness. We have been delivered, according to Colossians 1:13. We have been delivered from the power of darkness. How many feel delivered?
Amen.
All right, you don't have to feel it. Amen. You just want to know who you are and begin to what act. Amen. Accordingly. But of him are ye in Christ Jesus. Everybody repeat that name. But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us what? Wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption. That's saying a mouthful. Christ has become your wisdom. Amen. Christ has become my wisdom, your wisdom. Amen. You know, most times people don't realize how important wisdom is. If you would ask the average person, give a list of 1 to 10 of the things that mean the most to you, most people probably would say Jesus, maybe a few would say Jesus. Terms of things that's most valuable are things that you, most people desire. If you had a list that you were asking people to respond to, name 10 things that you feel that's most vital or most important to you. How many people would say Jesus?
Amen.
Amen. Some probably second would say what, money? Somebody probably would say health. Somebody probably would say what, peace. Love. Okay, what else, y'all?
A husband.
A companion. All those things would, you know, those things probably would be at the top of your list. But I would think that the thing that is most important for all of us would be what? Wisdom. Amen. The Bible says it's more precious than rubies and gold. Because all of the things that you desire, amen, cannot be compared to what? To wisdom. All of the things that you could desire couldn't be compared with wisdom, because wisdom is the ability to use what? Knowledge to get that up, to translate that into all of the things that you desire. Wisdom, the Bible says, God give it to a man that's good, gives him what? Wisdom. Amen. Hallelujah. So if you have wisdom, you have it all. Amen. You have it all, because God can get everything to you if you have wisdom. And by the way, there's righteousness and what? Sanctification and what? Redemption. Those four things Christ has already been made unto us, all of these things. In other words, we have we have received the wisdom of God, we have become the righteousness of God, and we have been what? Sanctified and made holy or set apart, and we've been delivered or redeemed. Christ has redeemed us from what? The curse of the law. Because he was made the curse for us. Amen. Praise God. Now over in James, I just want to just turn there just for a second. The book of James 3 speaks about wisdom. 3:17, but the wisdom that is from above is first pure, then what? Peaceable. Is gentle and easy to be entreated, is full of mercy and good fruits, without partiality and without hypocrisy. When those virtues demonstrated or manifested in your life, it's going to bring you every desire that you ever could long for. Amen. pure, peaceable, gentle, easy to be entreated, full of mercy and good fruits, without partiality and without hypocrisy. Amen. So those are the things that Christ has been made unto us. He has become all of this to us. He said, our redemption. We were redeemed through what the price that he paid for us over 2,000 years ago. We are redeemed and we are healed, we are blessed, we are preserved, we have victory, we have deliverance through what Christ is presently doing for us, amen, in his what, high priest ministry. You know, if you could give a definition of the grace of God, a lot of times people give things like this: God is doing for you what you can't do for what yourself. God's unmerited what, favor. The definition, God's riches at what, Christ is what. It's, there are many ways you can describe the grace of God, but the one that would include all of the things that Christ has done and all of the things that Christ is doing in you, amen, can be stated this way: is the sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ. The sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ and what Christ is presently doing through us through the power of the Holy Spirit today. Amen. That's enough to praise God for. That's enough to be very happy for. That's enough to be very well excited about. And I think that there's no other way to express and to articulate the things that God has done for us then to what, as Hebrews 13:15 says, amen. That kind of sums the whole thing up. We need to keep in the forefront of our minds the thing that God has made us, the thing that we have become as a result of the price that Christ has made. Amen. That scripture, Hebrews 13:15, is a scripture that by the Bible talks about. I mean, this scripture kind of puts it all in a nutshell. It says, by him, amen, Hebrews 13:15, everybody, by him, therefore let us what? Offer the sacrifice of praise to God. What? Amen. Let's read it again. By him, therefore, let us offer continually. That is what? The fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. You know, that scripture is a very powerful scripture because it says that the sacrifice of praise, offer the sacrifice, is always the best that you can offer. Amen. How many offer to God the best you have? Bless the Lord, all my soul, all that is within me. Amen. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget what? Not all of his benefits. It's a blessing to be able to praise the Lord and to appreciate all of the things that Christ has done for us. Amen. You might not be able to recapture, you might not be able to remember all of the things that Christ has done for us. But I believe that there, you should put forth a concerted effort to find out as many things that God has done for you as you what possibly can. Amen. I feel like shouting now. Even, you know, the scripture says there's life to them that what? Find. I mean the word, the things that God has done for you. Life. How many believe there's life in the word? It's life to them that what find it is healing to all of what your flesh. So you need to know what God is offering you. You need to know what's available. If the scripture says he's blessed us, his divine power has blessed us with what? Everything that pertains unto life and unto godliness. Yes, yes. If the word says that we ought to be concerned about what these things are. I mean, this is what God's offering. And the scripture says the promises of God are all one. Yea. And amen. Hallelujah. 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 So you want to be able to recollect, you want to be able to keep at the forefront of your mind every blessing that God, that means, that's the reason why the scripture says we need to what? Meditate day and night. Because you don't want these blessings to what? To go unclaimed. Your joy needs to be full. How many believe that? And I believe that when you glory from, amen, really search the scriptures and find out, this is the scripture that I consistently try to get over, but, you know, sometimes it's kind of hard, but sometimes people hear you and they, what, don't hear you. Some people have determined, you know, how much they want to receive. But I believe that, amen, we ought to go for what all that God has for us. Philemon 1:1, it says, verse 5 and 6, it says, hearing of thy love and faith which thou hast toward the Lord Jesus and toward all saints, that the communication of thy faith may become what? Effectual by the what? Acknowledging of every good thing which is in you in Christ Jesus. Everything that Christ has made you or provided you. Amen. All of these things should be something that you are consistently communicating. You are consistently what declaring. Amen. See, this is the only way that what God has done for you. Everybody just said what God has done for you. How many appreciate what God has done for you? But how many know that everything that God has done for you is not always what God is what is doing in you? How many want the blessings to be done in you? How many want to experience the reality of what all that God has provided? Amen. Praise God. But the scripture says that it's the communication of your faith. You have to communicate. See, faith is more what? Confessing and calling the things that what be not as though they what are. How many can say amen? Amen. You have to be able to what? To recognize what God has what? Has done for you. Amen. And then you need to what? You need to what? Begin to what? Affirm that. Amen. And after you affirm it, then what? You need, amen. God says that, Hebrews 13:15, it's offer the sacrifice of praise to God, what? Continually. That means what? That means that before God can do it in you, you have to praise Him. You have to affirm it. You have to what? Praise Him for the what? The fulfillment of that promise in you before that promise actually what? Manifests in you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. How about you just lift your hand and say, as He is, so am I.
As He is, so am I.
Lift your hand and say, I can do all things through Christ.
I can do all things through Christ.
Christ is working in me.
Christ is working in me.
His will.
His will.
And the ability.
And
to do all that He has called me to do.
All
I can do all things. He affects you. Effectually, everybody just say, He effectually worketh in them that what believe. Amen. He's working in me. Amen. How many can say amen? He's working. His power is in me. Hallelujah. The exceeding greatness of God's power. How many know the Holy Spirit is the exceeding greatness of God's power? The Bible says that we ought to pray that the eyes of our understanding might be what? Enlightened. Hallelujah. How many can just say that with me? Amen. Pray that the eyes of what? My understanding might be what? That we might know the what?
Hope.
Hope of this calling. Ah, yeah. How many know that God is, hallelujah, is calling us to a higher hope? Amen. Praise God. Even there's a whole lot of things that God has what? Provided us. Amen. These promises are what? Sure to every seed. Amen. His word will not ever what? Return void. God will stand behind his word to what? To perform it. How many can just say God will stand behind his word to perform? If you want him to perform it, amen, you need to what? You need to what? Affirm it. Stand behind his word to what? Perform it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I thank God today that sacrifice of praise need to be what? Offered continually. Amen. Continually. Just keep what? Praising him. Keep holding up the word of God. What? Before him. How many know that he's faithful? God's covenant, he will look, never will break it. Neither will he what? Alter the thing that have what? Gone out of his mouth. Amen. Lift your hand and say, God is faithful. Faithful is he that called me. And faithful is he that will do it. Lift your hand and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You're a faithful God. Glory. Faithful God. Faithful. Say it. Faithful God. Keep in covenant with them that what? Love him. But those that obey him. Those that walk before him with all of their heart. God is a faithful God. And he will never, never suffer his faithfulness to fail. How many can say amen? Oh, just thank him for his faithfulness. Thank him for his faithfulness. Thank him for his faithfulness. Praise God. I got some scriptures that I want to continue with. 2 Corinthians 5:21. Amen. This scripture shows the reason why his faithfulness won't fail. 2 Corinthians 5:21. Hallelujah. 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 2 Corinthians 5:21. It says, for he had made him to be what? Sin. Amen. Just read that again. He has made him to be what?
Sin.
All right. Who did what? You know sin. That we might be made. Okay. Now all of the blessings and all of the mercies that God has provided us, they all came through what? Jesus Christ. Even from the beginning of time. The Bible says in Psalms 145 verses, I believe 8 and 9, you can just turn there. It says, God is gracious. That means he's disposed to showing favors. See, God is really for you. Amen. He loves you a whole lot. He loves you just as much as he loves Jesus. How many believe that? Amen. God is for us. Glory. And Psalms 145, verses 8 and 9 says the very same thing. Psalms 145, verse 8 and 9. Let's read it together. It says what?
The Lord is
gracious. All right. Gracious means he's disposed to what? Showing favor. I mean, he wants to bless you, and he wants to bless you what? Real, real bad. Amen. He is what? He's full of compassion, and he's what? Slow to anger, and he's of what? Great mercy. Amen. The second part of it says what? God is what? He's good to what? And his what? Tender mercy are over all of his work. Now this scripture shows that God is what? Full of compassion. You know, we don't have to twist his arm. God is not a tight one. You have to what? Twist his arm, because if he didn't want to bless you, amen, he never would have what? Made these provisions for you. He never would have what? Sent Jesus over 2,000 years ago. Amen. So that shows that God delighteth in mercy. Amen. How many believe that God wants to give these blessings to you?
Yeah.
Even under the old covenant, it was because of Jesus' sacrificial death that was what? had even been manifested. In other words, he was willing to what, to pour out his blessings upon you on the basis of what Jesus would do in the future. Every blessing under the old covenant was available and possible, amen, under the sacrificial system. Because all of them pointed to who? Jesus. Amen. All of them pointed to Jesus. And when Jesus died and rose again and ascended to heaven, then all of those saints that were in paradise, when the consummation of the redemption took place, when Jesus had finished his work, then all of those people, they were what? They were, their spirits came out of what? Paradise. And they went to what? Went to heaven. Amen. Because the blood of Jesus had been what? Shed. He had become what? Sin. Amen. He had become sin. Scripture says he has abolished death. And has brought what? Life and what? Immortality to life through the gospel. Oh, praise him. How many glad that Jesus paid it all? Hey, how many glad that he paid it all? All to him we were. Oh, he became sin for us who what? Knew no sin. Glory. Now, all of those blessings out of the old covenant, amen, were possible because what? It was based on the redemption that would what, take place what, in the future. You know, that redemption has to be very powerful for all of those things to take place under the old covenant. Amen. Jesus' blood, hallelujah. Amen. Was the reason why God could manifest himself as Jehovah. Y'all name him Shalom. What else? Jireh. Y'all name him?
Rapha.
Rapha. Name some of them. Amen. God was able to what? To fulfill every need that people had when they had placed their trust in the what? Blood covenant, even under the Old Testament, because they all pointed to who? Jesus. Amen. How many can say God has given Jesus a name, and that name is the what? Above all names. It was healing in the name even before he gave his life. Amen. Because it was a promise. Amen. In the Garden of Eden, God spoke to Satan and said, amen, that the seed of woman will what? Bruise your head. Woo, glory. And talking to Satan, and you shall bruise his heel. I'm speaking about they will always, the church will always be persecuted. But to bruise his head, in other words, to destroy the lordship of the ruler. Satan's lordship will eventually be what? Destroyed through what? Jesus. Even as early as Genesis 3:15, God was pointing to the fact that what? Christ would become what? Sin for us. That's the reason why the Bible says for this purpose the Son of God was what? Manifested. That he might what? Destroy. Oh, glory. He's been defeated. He's paralyzed. Amen. All he is just a what? A roaring lion.
No chance.
He's roaring. Hallelujah. But what? His power, his ability has been what? Broken. And all he can do is what? Roar and scare you. Make you feel like he's what? He's bad. Amen. Praise him. Let me tell you, the work that Jesus has done, he ain't got to do it no more. It was a perfect sacrifice that what produced a perfect what? Redemption. We are redeemed from the curse of the law. We've been delivered from the power of darkness, and we've been translated into the kingdom of his dear son. I'm in Christ. Sister Dorothy is not in. On Christ, a solid rock, I stand. All on the ground. In the same sense, my hope is built. How many glad that your hope is built? See, we were redeemed by corruptible things like silver and gold. Amen. Praise God. But we were redeemed by what? The precious blood of Jesus. because the Bible says without the what? Shed of blood, there is no remission. But we have remission today through his blood. How many believe that all of your old sins and transgressions have all been well wiped out? Oh, if any man be in Christ Jesus, he's a what? New creature. All things are what? Passed away. Behold, all things are what? Oh, how many glad that Jesus paid the price to release us from the curse of the law. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says sin shall not have what dominion over you. For we are what? Bought with the price. How many glad that Jesus shed his blood? How many glad his blood wasn't shed in vain? Amen. But if Jesus' blood had been shed and shed only, and he had become our substitute and suffered, amen, in his spirit. Glory. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Okay. He was made sin. How many can say amen? See, it was more than just a physical thing. How many can say amen? You know, all the soldiers saw, all that Mary and all the disciples saw the day that Jesus was crucified, all they saw is what? A man hanging on the cross. Bleed, suffering, and what? Bleeding, hallelujah, right. And blood coming out of his side and out of his, what? Head, hallelujah, out of his hands and out of his feet. Yeah. But let me tell you, if you read how our heart shall die, Hebrew, I mean, Isaiah 53:9, amen, the Bible says his soul was made and what? An offering. He had to experience what? Death. Spiritual death. That was the most difficult challenge that Jesus had to face. He had to become sin for us who what? Amen. For us who what? Knew no sin. He didn't know no sin. But he had to become, in other words, our sins had to be what? Placed on him. Amen. The Bible said, amen. And this was manifested in the love of God, that he was sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might believe.
Yes, yes.
Oh, oh, I love that. How in this? And this was manifested. That's 1 John 3:4. Amen. 9 and 10. Amen. This was the love of God. How many believe that God loved you? Y'all believe he loved you as much as he loved Jesus?
Yes, yes.
No, I'm sorry. I can't go that far. Oh, how he loves you and me. Oh, how he loves you and me. He gave his life, what more could he give? Oh, how he loves you. Oh, how he loves me. Oh, how he loves you and me.
Preach it, brother, preach it.
And this was my offense. I love the end of this. Is that part of that right scripture? Is it 4:9? Okay, that's 9, right? So 8 and 9. And this was manifested. The love of God. Let's read it. That he what? Because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world. That we might what? Live. Oh, that we might what? Live. Read the next one. Wait a minute. The next one says what? Not that he we love him, but he loved us. Glory. That he sent his Son to be the what? Propitiation. That's been the sacrifice for our sin. How many love him? How many love him? Oh, shut up. If you really love him, every once in a while you say, Lord, hallelujah. You love me before you love me before I love you. Amen. I'm bought with a price. Lord, I thank you that what you paid to the price of your blood. Not only did he pay the price of his blood, but he became what? Sin for us. Our sins were laid on him that caused him to die spiritually. Turn to Isaiah 53, verses 9 through 12. That scripture should show that Jesus tasted death, and it wasn't easy. It was a high price tag that he paid. But he did it because what? He loved us. Oh, yeah. The Bible says, amen, and this was manifest in the love of God, that he what? Sent his son in the hope of the world that we might what? Live through him. Glory. That scripture. 53 verse 9. Okay, let's read that. Isaiah 53 verse 9. And he made his grave with the wicked. This is Jesus tasting death, made his grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death. That meant that the death thing is plural. Amen. Most times people can only see the physical aspect of Christ's suffering. But Isaiah went behind the scene and he took it a little further. And he saw what? The spiritual.
Yes, preach.
Woo, glory. And he said that he made his grave. He was down there underneath the earth with a whole lot of what? Rich people.
Yeah.
Oh, this was among the wicked. Everybody said the wicked. The wicked. All right, what else they said? Because he had done no violence, neither what? Neither was deceived in his heart. Yet no sin, neither guile in his heart. Okay, let's read the next. And he made his, okay. Yet it what pleased the Lord to what? He has put him to what? All right. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall what? See his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. Just keep on. Rolling it down, the next verse. He shall see and shall be satisfied. And by his knowledge shall my righteous servant justify many. For he shall what? There. Won't that make you always want to cry? Amen. Turn to Acts 2:24. You see that when he had pleased God, when he had suffered until God accounted his suffering sufficient,
yes, Lord,
to release the human race.
Yes.
The Bible says that God was what? God was pleased, and God raised up back from the dead. But the scripture says, whom God had raised up, having loosed the pains of what? Death.
Yeah,
no. Amen. One translation says the pains, P-A-N-G-S. If you really want to understand the horror, all the agonies that took place during that 3-day period when Jesus was underneath the earth with the wicked, it was the most agonizing experience that you will ever want to envision. It was just really an agonizing thing. You know, many times people don't think that Jesus paid an awesome price. The Bible says he paid it with utmost fathering. And I think that Jesus went through all of that, glory, hallelujah. I think that we ought to recognize that what? He paid a price, an awesome price. Glory. Couldn't we just lift up our hearts and just affirm something? Jesus, you became sin for me who knew those things. Say something. If he just, amen, became sin for you, you ought to what? You ought to affirm it. Whom God hath raised up, having loosed the pains of what? Death. See, that's when your salvation became what? Became secure. When Jesus had paid the price, and he had agonized and gone through all those agonies underneath the earth.
Yeah.
Amen. If you want to get a full view, read Psalms 88. The Bible says, God, what? He looks, but that was when our salvation was born. Down in the pit of hell, Jesus, what? He paid the price. He was in agony. He was in, I would say, travail. He was suffering. God laid all of his wrath hard upon him because he was paying the price for the entire human race. Amen. But when the price had been paid in full, glory, the Bible says Jesus, amen, he was what? He was delivered from the pains of death. How many glad? When he was delivered from the pains of death, I was delivered. Amen. He was what? Raised again when what he had paid the price for our justification.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that again. He was offered up for our offenses.
Yeah.
But he was raised again when he had suffered until the price was paid for us to be justified.
Yeah.
How many glad that Jesus paid it all?
Yeah.
When he had satisfied God's demand, the grave could hold him no longer. Bible says it was impossible for him to be holding by the grave any longer because he had met God's word demands. How many can praise the Lord? Amen. Because the scripture says, amen, we, Colossians 1, 21 through 23. I want you to go back to that scripture. But the Bible says, by the price that he paid, he will justify what men. Our knowledge of the price that he paid, our knowledge of the gospel, if you really understand what happened, those 3 days, the Bible says that will bring what? Justification.
Yeah.
Amen. To all from all things.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. I'm glad that we've been redeemed from the curse of the law. I'm glad that God delivered us from the power of darkness.
Yeah.
Bible says when we were sometimes alienated, Colossians 1, 20, 1, 2, 3. Colossians 1, 21, 22, 23. Amen. Amen. We, and when we were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by what? Wicked works. Yet now hath he what? Reconciled. He's brought us back to God.
Yeah.
The Bible says he was one of the just for the unjust to what? Bring us back. How many know Satan took us away? I'm so glad Jesus is in me.
Yeah.
I'm so glad Jesus is in me. I'm so glad Jesus is in me. Satan had me bound, but Jesus
set me free.
Satan had me bound, but Jesus lived in me. Satan had me bound,
but Jesus set me free. Singing, Lord, hallelujah, Jesus set me free.
Oh, this is your scripture here. And you that were what sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by what? Wicked words, yet now have he what? Reconciled. All right, let's move. When you take all of this in the body of his flesh through death to present you what? Unbelievable and unreprovable in his sight right now. That's not when you get to heaven. That's not in the sky by and by. When you die, it's right now. How do you know that his blood can remove every stain? Against me no longer. The Bible says, who can lay anything?
charge to God so well. How many glad that God has fixed it up for us? The devil messed us up, but what? God fixed it up. How many can say amen? How many can lift their voice that I've been delivered from the power of darkness? And I've been translated, I've been transplanted into the kingdom of his grandson. Amen. I have redemption through his blood, even the remission of all my sins according to his word. Riches. Hey, I'm redeemed. There's a song I can sing, my heart that the angels can sing. I've been redeemed and I've been what? Washed in his blood. Let's go to Romans 8:29. We just about done. Hallelujah. Romans 8:29. Amen. Praise God. If God didn't spare his own son, that's the scripture I want to start at. If God didn't spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all.
Right.
Hallelujah. How shall... All right, go to the next scripture. Okay. 32. God didn't spare his own son. Everybody read it with me. He that spared not. Say it again.
He that spared not his own son.
But did what?
Delivered him up for all.
How shall he not what? Also what? Freely. Okay, just keep on going. Who shall lay anything? It is God that what? Read that again. Who shall lay anything? Any charge? Glory. To the devil can't bring you under condemnation. The scripture says there is therefore what? God's work is perfected through what? Christ is perfectly perfected. Amen. He can't undo what Christ has already done. If Christ set you free, he the Son set free shall be what? Free. And free. You ought to be singing, I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus set me free. It is God that what? Justified. See, I have just as much right to come before in the presence of God, come before his presence, as much right as God has to sit on his own throne. Because he's the one that planned it, he's the one that wrought it, and he's the one that what? Stands behind it, because Jesus is there at the right hand of God. can do sin in the flesh. He put sin out of business. If you're in Christ, how many say that the born of God does not what? Officially commit sin. For what? The seed remains in him, and he cannot sin because he's born of God.
He carried my sickness. Lifted as a heap over sickness too. Steadfast.
All right, you may take your seat up.
This time you just want to make a decision that you're going to place your trust in the Lord, and you want to agree with somebody in faith for a specific need that you might have. You might feel free. You may feel free to come forth at this time. But the work has already been done. And Jesus is at the right hand of the Father. He's listening for you to what? To utter that prayer. To come into agreement, to affirm his word. The Bible calls him the high priest of your what? Confession. The apostle of our confessions. He's waiting for that word, affirmation, for you to embrace the provisions that he has already made available to you. He's waiting for you to say something. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is there anyone that want to say so? That want to call the things that we know as holy God? Want to hook up with the word of God? Bible says the word is what? Life to them that find it. And it's healing to all of our flesh. Amen. If you believe that you overcame by his blood, amen, and that the word of your testimony, if you believe that's the victory that overcomes the world, amen, hallelujah. Stand on your feet and say, I believe, amen, that I overcome by the blood. I overcome. Say it, say, stand on your feet again. I overcome by the blood. Turn all the way around. I overcome by the blood. Amen.
Pursue his prey, he just watches it for a while. Just watches, Brother Holden. He watches and stares. And he just kind of watches it. And that's to make you afraid. But when he pounces, I mean, he has teeth. But the devil, I mean, he's been defamed. He has no teeth. And you got to realize that. Amen. We are more than conquerors. More than. Amen. Amen. Well, he's already a priest, so I'm not going to enlarge on that. But I am happy to give this report today. I want to give you a first. According to Sister Tia, and her records are always accurate, the men came in. We'd like to congratulate you, men. We'd like to congratulate you, men. $2,050. Isn't that wonderful? Yeah. Congratulations to the men. But ladies, women, we went over the top.
So brothers, y'all keeping your man $4,500. Everybody said so y'all not gonna know who to believe. Who won? Your brother must keep in mind, 4,500 of them. And the women, 33 something. Sister Deborah, you want to announce your. All right, you want to do it next Sunday? But just kind of promote, if y'all can get out a little early Tuesday night and hear Brother Scales, I think that'll be a blessing.
Yeah.
God bless you. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost rest and abide with us now and henceforth and forever. Everybody said together, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.